Hi friends, my name is Chaitanya Patke and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we are going to analyze the practice game which took place at the Gabba between India and Australia. India won a thriller by 6 runs, all thanks to the brilliance of Mohammad Shami. 4 wickets fell on the last 4 balls of the Australian innings, which includes 2 tremendous Yorker by Shami, and he bowled a slower bouncer, which indicates that he is up for the task. As we know that he has been officially named as the replacement of Jasprit Bumrah, who will miss out due to a back injury for a considerable period of time. And if you follow the trajectory of Mohammad Shami in the T20 format has been quite interesting. He hasn't featured in a single T20 since the last T20 World Cup, in which India had to face a disappointing first round exit without qualifying for the semis. But nevertheless, he looked in great shape in the last over, and that is a very interesting ploy by Rohit Sharma, because Mohammad Shami wasn't used in any of the first 19 overs. Specifically, that could be the plan of the team management, which includes Rahul Dravid and bowling coach Paras Mamre, that Mohammad Shami has to deliver in the death overs, at least a couple of overs, which Jasprit Bumrah usually does. But by the looks of it, he has got off to an excellent start. India were put into bat by Australia after Australia won the toss and chose to bowl first. India managed 186 for 7 in their allotted 20 overs. KL Rahul scored 57 of 33 deliveries, the Indian vice captain back in prime form, and this will be a source of lot of relief to the Indian fans. 6 boundaries, 3 sixes at a strike rate of 172.73, and his cover drive was excellent. Now, the KL Rahul's barometer of confidence is the cover drive. When he's playing that cover drive brilliantly well, you know that he's up for it. Couple of sixes towards the leg side as well, which indicates that his confidence is at an all-time high, and we need KL Rahul to deliver against Pakistan. So long may his form continue. He was eventually undone by Glenn Maxwell when Ashton Agar took a fine catch. Rohit Sharma scored 15 of 14 deliveries, which includes a boundary and a six. He was out trying to force the pace at a deep square leg. He tried to hit a deep sweep shot. Ashton Agar undone him eventually. Virat Kohli scored 19 of 13, which includes a boundary and a six as well. He looked good, but Mitchell Stark set him up nicely the previous 2 deliveries, and he was eventually undone by a bouncer, with Mitchell Marsh taking a catch at deep square leg. Surya Kumar Yadav once again continuing on his merry way, 50 of 33 deliveries, 6 boundary and a 6. Usual suspects area that he usually scores through the covers, over the covers as well. And he was actually hit by a Mitchell Stark bouncer on the grill, which shaked him, but not for a long time. So yeah, Surya's form is also essential for us in the middle order. He is capable of explosive starts, and he has done exactly that in this game as well. Hardik Pandya, I think a rare failure for him. 2 of 5 deliveries. Sky was undone by Kane Richardson. DK scored 20 of 14 deliveries, which includes a boundary and a 6. Sorry for that. Kane Richardson eventually undone him. Maxi took taking a simple catch, but now what signal does it send that Dinesh Karthik is preferred in place of Rishabh Pant, because it is a practice game. R11 is sorted, and unfortunately Rishabh has to wait for a long period on the sideline, because by the way things are going, Dinesh Karthik will be preferred into the playing 11. Akshar Patel scored 6 of 6, and Ravi Ashwin a fantastic 6 over. Third man in his first delivery, Kane Richardson eventually got him. A magnificent performance by Kane Richardson as well. 4 wickets in 4 overs and just gave away 30 runs. Bowled brilliantly well. He mixes his pace very well, slower bouncers and Yorkers. He has a great variation, and they were on full display against a full strength Indian team, so that will do his confidence a world of good. Mitchell Stark in 3 over gave away 20 runs and took a single wicket of Virat Kohli. Pat Cummins was expensive, 3 overs, 33 runs, no wickets. So was Stoinis. In 2 overs he leaked runs, 29 runs, just to 14.5. So a disappointing outing from the all-rounder. Glenn Maxwell in 3 overs gave away 28 runs and took a wicket, a decent effort. Ashton Agar in 4 overs, 36 runs, 1 wicket as well, 9 runs per over. Actually, he bowled pretty well, but due to the brilliance of Surya, his figures were spoiled. And Tim David bowled a single over. Saw him first time bowling for Australia, gave 7 runs. Australia were set a target of 187, which was difficult but wasn't impossible. Michelle Marsh got off to a flyer, 35 of 18 deliveries, which includes 2 sixes and 4 boundaries. Bhuvneshwar Kumar eventually undone him with a ripper of a delivery, but the signs were looking ominous for Team India. Aaron Finch has come back into form finally, I would say that. 76 of 54 deliveries, 7 boundaries, and 6s galore. He was eventually undone by Harshal Patel. Clean bowled him, but that will do Finch's confidence a world of good. And it was one of the area for concerns of Australia that skipper Aaron Finch form is not up to the mark. Hope this innings gives him the required confidence to go through the tournament and play in the way that we all know the prime Aaron Finch plays. Steve Smith didn't do his case any good. 11 of 20 deliveries, single boundary. He was undone by Yuji Chahal. There has been a lot of clamour about Steve Smith's place into the squad after the exploits of Cameron Green versus India and West Indies. So this was a pretty important innings for Smithy, but unfortunately he didn't make a mark. And I don't think that the Australian selectors will pick him for the first match. Marcus Stoinis scored 7 of 7. Arshdeep Singh eventually got him with a beauty. Virat Kohli took a stunner. A game to forget for Stoinis. 2 overs, 29 runs, not a wicket. Also disappointed with the bat. Tim David scored 5 of 2. He was a run out of a brilliant flick of Virat Kohli, and that showed how aesthetic he is, the standard of fielding that he sets, and how hungry he is for this World Cup. Pat Cummins scored 7, which Virat Kohli once again took a beautiful catch at long on. I don't think the catch will be bettered the whole tournament, but it won't count because this is a practice game. But the way that he took pull that catch off with athleticism, mind-blowing. Josh Inglis, 1 of 3, he was undone by Mohammad Shami in the last over. Ashton Agar was run out by Dinesh Karthik, slower bouncer by Mohammad Shami. As we know that he tried to smack the ball towards Steve square leg because 6 runs were required of 3 deliveries. You couldn't blame Ashton Agar for that. Mitchell Starc didn't face a single delivery, and Ken Richardson was undone by a blistering Yorker by Mohammad Shami in the last ball of the game. Bhuvi in 3 overs gave away 20 runs, took 2 wickets. Very respectable figures if you keep in mind the carnage that was going on when the openers Mitchell Marsh and Aaron Finch were present at the crease. Arshdeep Singh was expensive, once again didn't find his length, and he needs to work on it because there will be a lot of responsibility on Arshdeep because Jasprit Bumrah is missing. 3 overs, 34 runs, 1 wicket, not satisfactory that performance at all. Hardik Pandya in 3 overs gave away 29 runs. Actually, Aaron Finch took a liking to him, and much better was expected from Hardik, but unfortunately he couldn't deliver. Harshal Patel in 3 overs gave away 30 runs and took a wicket. If you don't judge him by his figures, actually he looked in good rhythm, but was unfortunate not to get more wickets. Yorkers, cutters, both excellent. R. Ashwin in 4 overs gave away 28 runs, also gave a good display. What I wanted to see from R. Ashwin is that he bowls more of off-spinning deliveries than his variations, and he did that. Wickets will come eventually, but the team management will do a toss-up between Yuji Chahal and R. Ashwin because you cannot play two spinners. 3 overs, 28 runs, 1 wicket for Yuji, the important one of Steve Smith, and Mohammad Shami, 3 wickets in the last over, gave away just 4 runs. India had to defend 11 runs, and yes, he gave a great account of himself. Mohammad Shami bowled the last over, and as I mentioned at the start of my video, this is the plan of the team, that 2 overs will be bowled by Shami in the death overs. As we know that his form is great in the IPL, in the T20, which is the premier T20 league in the world. He bowls wonderfully well in the power play, but tapers off in his last 2 overs in the death. So yes, signs are very encouraging. And touch wood, Shami's form may improve from this performance. So, 6 run victory, which will do our confidence a world of good. Next up is New Zealand. Interesting to see which players the management tries out. Will they try the bench strength or not? But all in all, such sort of wins increase the confidence and self-belief in the camp. And yes, all the best to Team India going forward. So how did you like my analysis of this match? Please tell in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for further notifications. We'll meet in the next video. Till then, everyone, bye. And I'm humbly requesting everyone, please subscribe. The quality of the video is not up to the mark. I sorry for that because there is electricity trouble here. But please give me the feedback. I will definitely look into it.